Welcome. In this episode, I attempt to cut the barrel bridge out of the watch plate that I've made and put the jewel in for the second wheel and test it out. Introduce to y'all, it's the one son of a musician, refuse to fall. Got the sunshine in December when the blues be strong, cause I choose to be whatever, be the bull like mom. But before I jump into making the barrel bridge, I'm going to countersink all the screw holes that I've made currently in the watch plate. I'm using the Bergeon 1897 countersink tools. These can be used for clocks and watches. I've kind of modified these by cutting them in half, and I use them in the pin vise, and it just makes it a lot easier, because to do the countersink, you just use this basic motion and you put pressure from the top, and it's just uncomfortable with the actual hardened steel cutter up against your finger than when it's in the pin vise and you're just rotating it like that. I've just super glued the layout of my shape onto the brass. Now I'm just going to go ahead with the saw and cut out the shape for my bridges. As you can see, I've screwed the barrel bridge onto the main plate. So I'm just going to file the outside edge here to shape. Then I'm going to file these lines to its rough dimensions. I can't see properly. This sketch that I have here on this piece of paper is really rough. I don't know if you can see that, but these holes that I had, they don't even line up because I drew this like off the PDF document in AutoCAD, so it's not very accurate for the hole alignments. I can't use this as a CAD drawing at all. But what I'm going to do is I file it to its rough shape, then I'm going to ream the hole for the second wheel jewel, then I'll chamfer the outside of the hole, press the jewel in, and test to see if it works, and then I'll move on to try and getting the shape down to its final dimensions. Let's begin. I'm not sure how exciting that I can make the video of just me filing the outside round of the barrel bridge into shape, so I'm just going to skip that part of me working on the movement. But when I go into like finishing it, I'll definitely show that. One thing that I'm going to mention though is in the future, I'm going to make a jig and I'll put it in the lathe and I'll just turn it down to its correct diameter before finishing, and it'll save a lot of time. Right now I've got my barrel bridge in a jar of acetone, and this will dissolve the super glue so I can take off the paper. Now the next step is to put the jewel in for the second wheel, and they're held into the plate by friction. They're called friction jewels. They are done by creating a hole which is 0.01 millimeters smaller than the outside diameter, so that's a hundredth of a millimeter. So the thing about the second wheel jewel in the 6498 movement, which is a bit mind-boggling, is that the outside diameter is 2.2 millimeters and there's no reamer for that size. So I'm going to have to ream this hole by hand to get it to its exact dimensions. Before I do that, I'll just check how far out I am. Well, that can't be good. So, change of plan. Before I ream this out, I've got to deal with this issue. So it seems like the center wheel hole, which is the first wheel, which is the first hole that I created. So the very first hole that I created in the watch movement that I was making entirely, I made the hole oversized for the jewel, which I was meant to make it undersized and then ream it open. It seems like the hole is out by, like the hole that I created is probably 200 to 300 larger than the outside diameter of the jewel, which is too big. And, you know, it's such a small amount, but, for watchmaking, it's a lot. And, well, that's watchmaking. So I was thinking there's a couple ways that I can go around to fix this. One is I can, punch some divots on the backside and try and close that hole a little bit in the brass, but I really don't want to do that just because it's a real shortcut method and it's not going to look good. What I've been thinking about is Seitz jewels come in all different shapes and sizes, so I'm going to jump on the computer and see what is available and if there's something that I can use which is the next size up, keep the same pivot hole, and I should be good to go. So I took measurements of the outside of the jewel, the actual pivot diameter of the second wheel, which is 0.64, and I took the height of the jewel. But if you go to the center wheel jewels, so if I click Seitz jewels, and I go to second, and I go to center wheels, it doesn't specify the height of the jewel on any of them, which is a bit concerning, only because the unknown that's throwing me off. I don't know, like, what height are these jewels going to come in? And, you know, how is that going to affect the way my movement looks? So I think I'm going to pull the trigger on this. I'm going to pull the trigger on a couple of reamers as well, just to get some new ones. They should be sharp cutting. The good thing, I guess, that if this thing works out, is that the center wheel is going to be 2.3 millimeters in diameter, which means I can use the 229 reamer that comes with the Seitz jewelling tool, and I don't have to use the hand reamer, which I have to be super careful, and it takes a lot longer than using the jewelling tool. It's weird that the movement comes with a non-standard Seitz jewel. I mean, if I go to the Bolly D website and I click ETA jewels, you can see here that 0.66 pivot hole, the 2.2, 0.45, that is the center wheel for the 6498, 6497 movement. They don't even have them in stock, they're on demand. But as you can see, it specifies the height and it's 2.2. So that means I would need a 2.19 reamer, but you can look anywhere. I've looked everywhere at all the supply shops. There's not a 2.19 millimeter reamer for the Seitz tool. It's very strange. If there is, if there is out there, please let me know in the comments. So things haven't planned out as I had hoped, but you know, nevertheless, it's all a learning experience. So that's where I'm at right now. I've ordered, I'm just going to wait for those things to arrive. So before I can jewel the second wheel, I have to wait for those parts to arrive. And they're coming all the way from UK. I live in Australia. And so it might take a week or so. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to continue filing down the barrel bridge to shape and then start progressing on the train wheel bridge. It'll be interesting to see how this goes. You know, I guess we have to see how things go. Unfortunately, I think I'm going to end the episode there. I'm just going to continue filing the barrel bridge to size, and then I'm going to start cutting out the train wheel bridge. And until the new jewel arrives, I won't be able to see if this whole barrel bridge works. I might finish the train bridge before I can test the barrel bridge. A bit of an underwhelming finish to this episode. Hopefully I can see in the upcoming videos on how this sort of all pans out. Thank you.